Welcome to CaseWare QuickVids. This QuickVid will demonstrate how to create new note content in the knowledge libraries to meet the needs of your organization. Before we begin, please see the QuickVid Knowledge Libraries overview for more information on the knowledge libraries and the steps to managing content within the libraries. As discussed in the QuickVid Knowledge Libraries overview, Financials is equipped with base content for statements and notes. These can be used as is or can be customized to suit your organization needs. While the process for working in the libraries is much the same, there are slight differences when working in the notes libraries. Let's look at an example to get a clearer picture on how this process works. I'm going to create a custom note for inventory that will only auto-generate if a balance exists. The first step is to review and select the content you would like to make available to users. Please refer to the QuickVid Knowledge Libraries overview for more details. I reviewed the CaseWare content and selected the content I would like to make available to my users. I have determined that there are some notes that need to be modified or added to meet the needs of our organization. I am now going to begin step 2 and create a unique custom note format. From the Document menu, select Add New Firm Content. The New Content Specification dialog appears, and it is used to decide where in the knowledge library a new note being created will be placed. The titles area, heading, topic, and subtopics correspond to the different branches of the knowledge library. This also ensures that the note inserts into the correct location in the financial statements. So, for area, I'm going to select Notes to the Financial Statements and continue down the items and use the dropdown to place my new note accordingly. You can customize the structure by adding new areas, headings, topics, or subtopics. However, the best practice is to use the structure provided. Once satisfied with my selections, I'm going to provide a name for the note. I will call my note Finished Goods. Click OK, and the knowledge index appears. In this dialog, we are going to select which note example I'm going to use as a base for my new finished goods note. Please note that if a certain base note doesn't suit your needs, you can select any note from the index as a base for the note. To locate an applicable note, you can use the Expand Collapse All button in the index, or you can simply use the Find to search for your note. I'm going to use a generic two-column format to base my note. Select the Note Radio button and click OK to insert the note into the knowledge library. The note can now be modified using all the tools and features found in Financials to meet the specific requirements. Even though I added only one note, I am able to add as many custom note formats using the method just outlined. You can easily create a new note using a combination of existing notes by clicking the button to the right of the note. Let's add some text to this note. Click the button to the right of Finished Goods, and the Knowledge Library Index will display. In the Knowledge Library Index, I'm going to navigate to the Generic Text Only option to insert it within the note. The text is added to the bottom of the note. I want to move the text before the table. To sort the note, right-click the Finished Goods heading and select Configure and then Sort Contents. The Manual Section Sort dialog will display. Select Section 2 and click Move Up button to move the contents above the detail table. I am now going to edit the move text. When the note is inserted into a client file, we want the details of the note to come from the trial balance. I'm going to change the table line items to mapping, and then I will link each line on the note to the applicable mapped numbers. I now want to set up rules so that when there is a balance for inventory in a client file, this note would automatically insert when the user accepts the prompt for adding recommended content. To do this, in the toolbar, click the Content Rules button. The Content Rules dialog will appear. The properties you choose here help to filter the content for the end users and reduce the amount of noise. This is where you will set the note to automatically insert into the client file using the auto-generate flag. I'm going to locate the custom note I added, which was placed within the assets hierarchy in the Knowledge Library index. Again, you can refer to the QuickVid Knowledge Library overview for more information on the settings in the content rules. To add the condition, you can simply type in the formula in the text field or click the List button to open the Explorer user prompt to enter the expression. This field uses CaseView functions. The simple formula we will add is the following. These conditions can get very complicated. Refer to the CaseView help for more information on CaseView functions. Lastly, to make this note auto-generate based on the selected conditions, select the auto-generate checkbox. Click OK to save and close the dialog. Now, when a new financial statement is generated or an end user accepts the prompt to add recommended content and the conditions are all met, this note will be included in the financial statements. I have now successfully added a new note to the notes library and set the rules by which end users will have access to the note. This concludes the QuickVid on creating alternative formats for notes. For additional resources, including documentation and online help, see the related links. Thank you for watching CaseWare QuickVids.